हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मिस्टर बसलिंगप्पा सुरेश कातराबाद, वर्किंग एज अ लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्मदेव दादा माने पॉलिटेक्निक बेलाटी सोलापुर। टुडे आई एम डिलीवरिंग लेक्चर ऑन सिंगल फेज एसी सीरीज सर्किट फ्रॉम द कोर्स इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट्स under the program electrical engineering semester 3. First we will see syllabus content. Generation of alternating voltage, phasor representation of alternating quantities, which is the first bit we have seen in last lecture. Second bit is RLC circuit elements, its voltage and current response. Third bit, RL, RC, RLC, AC series circuit, impedance, reactance, impedance triangle, power factor, active power, reactive power, apparent power, power triangle and vector diagram. Fourth bit is resonance, bandwidth, quality factor and voltage magnification in series RL, RC, RLC circuit. In this lecture we will see some basic definitions. First, RMS value. Second, average value. Third, form factor. Fourth, peak factor. Fifth, phase angle. First, we will see phasor representation of alternating quantities. The phasor representation is used to represent a sinusoidal quantity. Generally, alternating quantity is represented as sine wave or cosine wave with the help of phasors. Phasor is a straight line with an arrow marked on one side. Next, RMS value. It is that value of DC quantity which, when flowing through given circuit for a given time, produces the same amount of heat as produced by alternating quantity for the same circuit for the same time. Means, suppose we are taking simply a resistor and we are giving AC supply. When we are giving AC supply, that resistor will produce heat. Now we can replace this AC quantity into DC quantity, means DC supply. So whatever the heat will be produced by AC quantity, same amount of heat I want to produce by giving DC supply. So whatever the current or voltage required to produce the same amount of heat, that is known as RMS value. It may be a current or voltage. So therefore, definition is, it is that value of DC quantity which, when flowing through given circuit for a given time, produces the same amount of heat as produced by alternating quantity for the same circuit for the same time. Generally, it is denoted by VRMS or IRMS. It is given by VRMS equal to Vmax, means maximum voltage, into 0.707. In graph, we are showing here RMS value. Next, average value. It is that value of DC quantity which, when flowing through given circuit for a given time, transfers the same amount of charge as transferred by alternating quantity for the same circuit for the same time. Generally, it is denoted by V average or I average. For voltage, it is V average, or for current, it is I average. It is given by V average equal to V max into 0.637. In graph, we have shown here RMS value and average value. Here, we are giving AC supply simply we are taking a capacitor device and we are giving AC supply. Charge will be transferred. Whatever charge will be transferred by AC quantity, now I want to transfer same amount of charge by giving DC supply. So whatever the current or voltage required to transfer the same amount of charge as produced by alternating quantity, that is known as average value. Again, we are here showing average value. Next, form factor. Form factor, it is defined as, it is ratio of RMS value to the average value of alternating quantity, is known as form factor. Generally, form factor equal to RMS value divided by average value. In mathematical form we are writing here, that is form factor equal to. Now we have seen the RMS value definition. So RMS value is nothing but maximum value into 0.707 divided by. Average value is nothing but maximum value into 0.637. Maximum value will get cancelled. So 0.707 divided by 0.637 is nothing but 1.11. So finally form factor will be 1.11. Where it is used? Form factor is used to convert RMS value into average value, or average value into RMS value. Next definition, peak factor. Peak factor, it is a ratio of maximum value to the RMS value of alternating quantity. It is a ratio of maximum value to the RMS value of an alternating quantity. So we can write in mathematical form, it is given by peak factor equal to maximum value divided by RMS value. So maximum value divided by, instead of RMS value, we can write maximum value into 0.707. So maximum will get cancelled. 1 upon 0.707 means 1.41. That is a peak factor. So where we can use peak factor? Peak factor is used for designing the maximum voltage level, or in insulation designing we are using peak factor. Peak factor means maximum. Maximum factor we are deciding. So in insulation level, peak factor is used. Next, phase angle. Next definition is phase angle. The angle introduced in between alternating quantities. The angle introduced in between alternating quantities is known as phase angle. The angle introduced in between alternating quantity is known as phase angle. Means here we are showing waveform. Two alternating quantity, whatever the angle introduced between two alternating quantity, here we are taking voltage and current, two quantities. The whatever angle introduced between voltage and current is known as phase angle. So phase relates a full cycle or period of 360 degree as a reference. Here phi as a phase angle. Next, phasor representation of alternating quantity. So we have seen already, phasor representation is used to represent sinusoidal quantity. Generally, alternating quantity is represented as sine or cosine wave. Simply, phasor is a straight line with an arrow marked on one side. For sinusoidal quantity representation, we are using phasors. Phasor is simply an arrow mark, straight line with an arrow marked. Here we are showing, simply we are taking a phasor. This phasor is rotated with anti-clockwise. So when it is rotating anti-clockwise, initially waveform will be shown 0 position, next at phi position, that is omega t. As it is rotating, waveform is going increasing, reaching maximum value, and again it is decreasing, reaching 0. Again it is increasing in negative direction, again it will reach maximum, again it will decreases and reach to 0. Means here we are showing the phasor representation of alternating quantity. Simply, phasor is used to represent sinusoidal quantity. It is a straight line with an arrow marked in one direction. थैंक यू।